So CTV News is reporting an Indigenous mother in Manitoba is considering filing a human rights complaint after her child came home with an assignment featuring an offensive image of an Indigenous person on horseback attacking a horse-drawn carriage. So how would you, or how have you reacted to something like this in your life?
First of all, I just think about that child looking at that image and feeling devastated and hurt and confused. And then I think about the mother having to navigate that world, and it's so difficult. And I know that I can speak for this on a personal experience, and it's really, really difficult when you identify with this person, this image that is very, very negative, and it's in a school book, so therefore it should be law, right? And I think that the mother is considering, issuing a formal complaint, and I think that she should go ahead with that. But also, we can't forget the kids, and this is a teachable moment, and from the top down, these things have to stop. I grew up, when I went to school, my parents are Nigerian. I'm, Nigerian Canadian. And I remember, you go through the books and go, please don't let there be the image of an African who is topless and living in a remote field where it looks like they have absolutely no technology and no knowledge of self or what's going on. And so it's a very, very negative thing, and it's very stressful. And I think that you have to take action. And unfortunately for Black and Brown and Indigenous kids and families, we have to kind of gird our kids. We have to prepare them for this because we know it's coming. And every time that it does happen, hopefully your child will tell you about it, and then you have to discuss it, which is what happened in my case.
Yeah, and I think that in this case too, it's extra egregious because it was a math homework problem. So in math, like, there's no time for analysis of culture and story. You're solving a problem. And that is where I also was super concerned is, there is a lot of literature from the past that is problematic that may not be taught every day, but when it is taught, you can build in room for analysis and conversation with the students saying, this book is 100 years old. This is what was happening then. And this is why we have evolved and changed. Huckleberry Finn is an example of that. With a homework assignment that's a math problem, like it's literally a sheet of paper and it's, I don't know, whatever, like this carriage was going 5 kilometers an hour and the horse was going 7, whatever, and you're going to figure it out. And so that image gets kind of branded into someone's brain without that analysis. That's what I think is so concerning. And I'm also concerned that like only one parent complained.
Yes.
Like if the homework assignment was sent out to all kinds of parents, you shouldn't just be Indigenous to be offended.
I think the onus is on the person. I'm actually ashamed of the other families who are in this class. If you're a white parent, you should be noticing this stuff as well. And this goes out to like all the people who like say like, oh, I feel like I'm not racist because, maybe you don't have any people diversity in your community, but this is the opportunity where you're going to see these things. I was watching a Looney Tunes cartoon the other day with Jaya, and it was an old retro one, and I just turned it off. And it, because it was so deeply offensive. And then he asked me, of course, why I did. And so it was one of those, Rosie, to your point, it was a teachable moment. And Angie, I'm just curious, like how has this come up in your life? I mean, in your past even?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It has. And the thing is, we have to start recognizing that so much of the education system, both in the States and it sounds like even there in Canada, is still drenched in white supremacy. And we have to break that down and recognize it, if nothing else. And I know that catches people off guard, but it is. I look at the history that's taught here, specifically in America, in the schools, and the perspectives that are shown, the limited perspectives that are shown, and we never get the whole picture. So I dealt with it as a kid, and I remember an instance where there was actually an offensive drawing in a book, and my mom complained, but all the parents complained, and they got it changed quickly, and there was apologies, but that was 20 something years ago, and yet and still parents are still having to deal with these issues in the school system. We have a problem here.